For those of you who are unfamiliar, in February of next year, the Congress has mandated that Commission facilitate the transition from analog television to digital television.
I think we have a long way to go. The public's aware something's going to happen sometime. I think that's where we're at right now. They're not real sure the date. They're not sure if it's just the TV set in their garage.
The general message that folks are beginning to hear, which is that on or by February 17th, 2009, all full power broadcasts will transition from analog signals to digital signals.
Which means that every household in America can apply for up to two coupons of $40 each, and one coupon per box to help subsidize the purchase of the boxes, not the antennas or any other equipment, just the boxes.
87 different models that are out there right now made by different manufacturers. And what it is, it's just a box where instead of having the television antenna come and go into television like it typically did, into analog channels, you just hook it up here into a place where it says from antenna, and then there's another one that says to TV RF, and then you just put it in, plug it in, and you turn it on, you're supposed to get all the benefits of digital.
Not very many options in a lot of their markets. There's only one or two boxes on the shelves in many cases. And at this point, those price points are a bit higher than they will be in June and July. HearUsNow.org, that has a lot of the public policy, federal government kind of suggestions and advocacy materials. And the second is our magazine's website. And all of the information we have on DTV is available above the paywall. You don't have to be a subscriber to access any of this information. It's Consumer Reports. .org/DTV. Consumer Reports Labs have tested 14 of the converter boxes that are on the shelves right now, and will be releasing some data on which boxes tested well, which boxes tested not so well.
You don't need to go out and buy an HDTV for $2,000 to take the enjoy the benefits of digital television.
It is mygreenelectronics.org. So www.mygreenelectronics.org. There's a link to that resource and many others on the civilrights.org pages, which is www.civilrights.org/DTV. So you can go there, you can search by zip code and identify where there are recycling centers in your neighborhood, in your community, where you can take not just an analog TV, if that's your choice, but other household electronics as well. I think the very important thing to note is that there are people out there with messages that make it sound like you need to throw your television away, that your TV is not going to work after February 17th, and that's not the case.
The American Association of People with Disabilities is in Washington, D.C. We're a national nonprofit group. And we work very closely with other disability groups. And in particular on this issue, we've been working with the American Council of the Blind and the National Association of the Deaf, because people with sensory disabilities are the most extraordinarily going to be impacted by this transition.
23 million people that will have no access to news and information unless they take action by February 2009.
Let you know when a tornado's coming, let you know when a crisis is happening. So it really is a lifeline. So this isn't, you know, some people were painted, you know, whether you can get your reality TV show or this or that. This really is not a luxury that we're talking about. This is actually a fundamental right.
And that's one that the people who speak languages other than English who are going to be impacted by this are oftentimes those individuals who are least likely to receive traditional forms of public education outreach. So, you know, for example, the work that the federal government is doing to get the word out. And some of the public service announcements you see on full power broadcasts. So communities who speak languages other than English are really important for us to be thinking about as we go forward in doing this kind of education outreach. And the other thing to note is we've talked a little bit about low power, full power, you know, your eyes glaze over unless you're really technical. But this digital transition is a full power digital television transition. So television broadcasters who broadcast in low power, which oftentimes are the community broadcasters who oftentimes provide programming in languages other than English. They provide programming in language, in Spanish, in many Asian languages, for example, may not be and are not required to transition by February 17th. So you know, it could be that there are many people who will want to continue watching these. We hope they'll continue watching these in analog after the transition. So helping them know what converter boxes will easily pass through those analog signals is very important. So those are
DTV, train wreck or digital opportunity?
But the possibility of a train wreck. I was in the Clinton administration as Assistant Secretary of Commerce when we did the Y2K transition. And I can tell you what a coordinated public sector, private sector, interagency effort looks like. And compared to what we did then, this DTV transition is pretty much of a stealth operation so far. We had outreach to the private sector. We had the cooperation of the private sector. We had unified messages. We were hauled down to the White House on a monthly and then a weekly and then almost a daily basis as we got closer to January 1st, 2000. And we knew damn well that the President and the Vice President were watching, and we better get this one right. And at the end of the day, folks said, well, what'd you do all that for? You know, there wasn't a big problem here. Wouldn't that be a happy outcome of the DTV transition? But it's not going to happen that way. So we made this decision that at one date we're going to pull the lever for the entire United States of America and transition everybody. I had the opportunity last November to go to the United Kingdom and meet with the folks who are doing the DTV transition over there. You know how they're doing it? Over a five-year period. And they go into every locality, and I happened to be over there when they went into the first town, which was Whitehaven, a place of 25,000 people. They went in and did all the public education. They explained what had to be done. If you were an older person or a person with disabilities, they came in and hooked up your new equipment for you. And then they pulled the lever on one channel to see how that would work in that one town of 25,000 people. Did the mid-course corrections that were necessitated by that, came back a month later and did the other channels, and then moved on to the next town, the next town, the next town.
Another concern is that similar to that, 5 to 10% of antennas that people are using today aren't going to work. So say you set up your TV set and you got your converter box and you successfully scan it and it still doesn't work. You're going to think, well, I better take this back to Best Buy. No, it's because your antenna's no good, but how did you know that? And where's your technical help to know it was your antenna problem? And who's going to educate people about these things? I mean, there really is a lack of preparation that is astounding given the magnitude of what we're doing here. It takes a long time to get a plan in place to help out tens of millions of Americans on one day and get all those resources in place. We better figure out a way to do it, and fast.